Welcome to episode 43 of Season 3 of DJ Tops. Remember to subscribe if you like the video. Today, I will be talking about the Halloween tree. The narrator, Ray Bradbury, describes one small American town's preparations for Halloween night. Four friends are shown at the respective homes, donning costumes as Billy, Jenny as a witch, Love as a mummy, Wally as a monster, and Tom Skeleton as a skeleton. The plan, they pretty me up with their best friend, Joe Pitkin, but he doesn't appear. They go to Pip's house and see him being loaded into an ambulance with his parents riding along with him. He has written them a note explaining that he is going to the hospital for an emergency and be dead to me, and that they should celebrate without him. They feel they can't drop Harvey without him, so they follow the ambulance to visit him at the hospital. Tom suggests a soul cut through the spooky woods. The dark and eerie ravine, they see what looks like a treacherous Pip running on the ravine trail, and Tom leads them on, convinced that Pip has designed a elaborate hoax for them. The group lives as a Pip, who discovers near a town and dog gained mansion, a man named Carpenter, Mark, Truman, Goose, Debbie, Seth. Monsoon expresses disappointment that none of the children know what the culture sunrise. He reveals that he is actually the ghost of Pip. Pip sits and seals a pumpkin with his face carved into it from my son's Halloween tree of jack-o'-lanterns. Tom begs my son to let them come with him and help bring back Pip. My son initially refuses, but relents. If they could keep up with him before dawn, then they might be able to retrieve the pumpkin and get Pip back. We're also going on a scavenger hunt of sorts to learn about the specific of the costumes and the origins of Halloween. They begin their pursuit of Pip, traveling back in time by rippling down a old soldier's pencils from a nearby barn and crafted a giant kite with the children hanging at a weighted tail. First they travel to ancient Egypt to learn of the celebration called the Feast of the Ghosts, following Pip's spirit to a tomb in a pyramid. They learn the significance of mummification. Love finds a weak spirited Pip and begs him to come back. As the priest begins to embalm trying to embalm Pip, Ralph scares them away by pretending to be a real mummy, but when Mabel confronts him again, Pip uses his pungus magic to escape him, and the group chases him through time once more. Next, let's at Samhain's during the Dark Ages in England. They witness rituals carried Som danses en fyrtet av det og kaffe. Nei, kaffe. Det brus en fyrtet av det og kaffe må æs. Man bare så tidligste briefly appears as a black cat. They come across a field of snow being often said by the being harvested and made into blue. And you discover a cover of witches changing and celebrating the new year. Mount Sunwell helps the children escape a mob of empty woods spirituals by making them some of the blue fire, Daniel's pet office blue, in attempt to snatch away his pocket. Jenny catches Pip, but is afraid of losing him. He encourages home and then don't away. They follow him to Fred's and arrive at the unfinished Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. Roman that the cathedral's use of gargoyles and demons. The children use Mount Sunwell's magic to finish the cathedral. And Wally climbs to reach a pear-shaped gargoyle that is holding Pip's pocket. He begs Pip to be strong. Pip flees again and the group follows. Finally in Mexico, they learn the significance of skeletons the Los Muertos, the Day of the Dead Festival. They find a very weak Pip in a catacombs. Tom manages to get to Pip and apologizes to him, admitting he feels guilty the whole ordeal because he was with for something bad to happen to Pip so he could eat the grapes lunch. Pip smiles and forgets to promise to him. Promises to let him meet any type he wants. Pip's spirit crumbles into dust and is gone. Now, Salem tells the children they did not make it in time, and Pip is now his property. The children offer 8 years off The children offer The children offer 8 years The children offer him 8 years off of the end of each of their lives in exchange for for Pip's return. He accepts the gift and gives each of them a piece of a circle candy skull with Pip's name on it to eat. Sarah the Mug. Pip's spirit then flies and he scratches his He and he snatches his pocket back from Mount Sunrise and flies out. The group is then immediately transported home to America in the present day. Having completed the book, so do you, Jimmy? The children go to Pip's house to see if the experience was real, and are delighted to see him back from the hospital. At the mansion, Mom, someone blows out his pocket candle, turns into smoke, and disappears. The Halloween tree is the Halloween tree is assassinated by the summer blowing all the pumpkins away. All except for Pips, with the children rescued by their sacrifice. This is a truly amazing story about success for kids. Keep and hopefully you off the ambulance to save a friend. It's something you don't see often, but it is a sweet story. Remember, if you want to listen to my podcast, Animation Chat, where I compare all new shows, there are links to what I posted in the description. Thanks for watching. Remember, on the digital studio, subscribe and ring the bell to be the first to see my video.